Alright everybody, what's going on? It's Thundershot, and welcome to another Ask Thundershot, Ask FM thing. I leave my link in the description down below to my Ask FM. You ask me questions, I answer them. So, I got a lot of mixed feedback last time. First of all, a lot of people wanted me to do a face cam. I'm sorry that ended up, I tried to do one this morning, but it's going to end up taking more work than I originally thought. And this is something I have to get right on the first time, otherwise I lose a bunch of questions, because I exit questions when I'm done with them. So, face cam will be coming. I can't guarantee it'll be this week. Obviously it's not this week, or next week, but as soon as I find out how exactly I can do that setup, I will be doing that setup. So face cam is on the way. Aside from that, I got a lot of mixed feedback because last time in the last Ask FM special thing, I did one big 30-minute part. I asked you guys if I should cut it up into two 15-minute parts, if I should just keep one 30-minute, and the responses were kind of mixed. Some of them said split it up to 15-minute parts. Some of them said split it up to 30-minute parts, which, man. Others of them said keep it one big chunks. People were saying 30 minutes is too long, so I think I found a compromise. I think what I'm going to do instead to give you guys a little bit more content and kind of do the best of both worlds is instead of 15 minutes, I'm going to do 20-minute videos, but I will try my darndest to never go over 20. So it'll be 20 sub-20-minute videos, and I will split it up into two parts. So I'm going to spend 20 minutes now doing questions from the bottom up, and then I'm going to spend 20 minutes on Thursday, in Thursday's video, I should say, doing questions from the top down. So, oh my god, Shadow of Mordor, I'm so hyped for Shadow of Mordor. By the way, if you're watching this on Tuesday, if you're watching this on September 30th, Shadow of Mordor is coming out, and oh my god, am I completely excited for that. In every way, shape, and form. I'll be live streaming it as soon as my copy comes in, so like, anywhere between, probably closer to 4, anywhere between 4 and 5 or 5:30 at the latest Central Time, I am going live with Shadow of Mordor, and it's going to be absolutely amazing. Anyway, let's get into these questions today. What is with the avatar? So let me pull that up real quick. I have an image that I've used before if you've been with my channel for a little while now, and I find it hilarious, but this is my avatar. Nope. Can you guys see that right? Yeah, you can see it good. All right, this is my avatar. It's just a picture that makes me laugh all the time, and I figured when I link my Ask FM, nobody, like, people can find me on Twitter, right? People can find me on Facebook and find me on YouTube and Twitch, so I use images that, I don't know, are images for that, but then it's like Ask FM, you already know who I am if you're coming to Ask FM, so I just use this image because it makes me laugh every single time. There's another original picture that's just this lady with the couch and with the caption, "That makes me moist." Looks like she's like a school principal or secretary or something taking a school photo, but it's this really weird looking lady, and they put her in a cloister, I don't know, but it's funny to me. So that is what's with that avatar. I don't know, I like it, it makes me laugh, so there it is. Hope it makes other people laugh too. What is your favorite DBZ saga? Cell Saga. I don't have to think very hard about that one. Cell Saga. Goku's family. Goku, Super Saiyan 1, Teen Gohan, Bardock, Goten, Chi-Chi, and Raditz, or Vegeta's family, Vegeta, Teen Trunks, King Vegeta, Kid Trunks, Bulma, and Tarble. Who do you think would win in any form except Super Saiyan God? Well, Goku's family. Mainly because Goku, Super Saiyan 3... would be strong enough to take on all of them. Unless, I mean, if he's excluding Super Saiyan God, I'm assuming he's excluding that one time Vegeta got mad for a second and got strong for just a little bit. So other than that one time when Vegeta was strong for like 4 seconds, Goku Super Saiyan 3 could easily take on all of them. So it's like, it's almost like once you get the strongest person in DBZ, especially when Goku is that head and shoulders above everyone else, an entire Super Saiyan level above everyone else, it's almost like the rest of the people don't matter. If nobody can take him on, if no one can at least put up a decent fight to Goku, then they're really, you know what I mean? But basketball fan, I watched during the finals. I don't like that they traded Andrew Wiggins. I wish he would have stayed. I wish him and LeBron would have torn it up in Cleveland. I think Andrew Wiggins and LeBron would have been a better combination than Kevin Love and LeBron, but that might just be me. They needed 3-point shooters, I guess. The Queen Kareem. Okay, good question. Super Saiyan 2 Gohan versus Super Saiyan 2 Majin Vegeta. Super Saiyan 2 Majin Vegeta, because they stated before that Vegeta and Goku both, at their natural Super Saiyan 2 states, obviously Goku was stronger before Vegeta went Majin, and he was still stronger after that because he had Super Saiyan 3. But Vegeta and Goku both were, it was stated that they were both stronger than Goku, or than Gohan was when Gohan fought Cell. So, and then Vegeta got the Majin boost, which would push him even further beyond. But no, thank you, Jason Hella, for the question. But that is definitely Majin Vegeta. Let me get my timer here so I can see a little better. Hello, does Kwame actually live in Antarctica, or is he just kidding around? I'm extremely curious because, like a month ago, he said he lived in Miami. Also, what is your favorite food? No, Kwame legitimately lived in Antarctica, and I think, honestly, you might have to ask him. I'm not going to lie, it's been just a little while with all the Xenoverse stuff and all the craziness going on, and Kwame being back in school and everything. Kwame legitimately lived in Antarctica, but I think he moved to New Zealand. You might have to ask him. Go to his Ask FM or not. I might be pulling that out of my butt, but I swear in a video, he said he moved to New Zealand. But he was in Antarctica, and then with school, I don't know if he moved before school or what, but like I said, we've both been busy, haven't got the chance to talk with him in a little while, but he legitimately moved to New Zealand, I think. But thank you, Devin LaBombe, for the question. But no, I'm 99% sure he moved. You'd have to ask him, though, because I can't tell you 100%, I know. But anyways, I thought it was in his Ask FM that he's moved to New Zealand. But anyways, sorry. I was wondering, what is the Gogeta with white hair? Every time I search pictures of Super Saiyan 4 Gogeta, I always see pictures with white hair. And one in Dragon Ball Z Budokai Tenkaichi 2, the white hair one is an alternative color for Super Saiyan 4 Gogeta. If it's an alternative color form, that might just be an alternative thing from Budokai Tenkaichi. I also think either Dragon Ball AF or Absalon, the fan fiction, had Super Saiyans using white hair. That's my best guess. I'm not 100% sure what to tell you on that one, but that's my best guess. But nothing with white hair was ever legit. Like, no Super Saiyan transformation has ever been in Dragon Ball Z with white hair, or even GT for that matter. Well, kind of, I mean, baby, but, you know, he doesn't count. I know you like Shadow the Hedgehog, so could you answer this question? Who would win in a fight, Goku or Sonic? We got that one in the last Ask FM. Bruce Lee versus Muhammad Ali. Bruce Lee. He's too fucking quick, man. He's too good. Have I watched Gurren Lagann? No, but I have been harassed to watch Gurren Lagann a lot, and I should get to it eventually. If it's on Netflix. If it's not on Netflix, I might have more trouble getting to it, but there's that. Thundershot. Don't you think that Goku and Superman wouldn't fight because they're both great in their own ways? Superman wouldn't kill Goku, or Goku wouldn't kill Superman. I'd say it's a stalemate. If they decided to fight, nobody wins. Kinda. I mean, Superman's been shown being a dick, but let's assume for whatever reason, like, they wouldn't actually have a reason to fight. They would both kind of be doing their thing, protecting the Earth. I think Goku would want to fight Superman. I don't think they would try to kill each other, but I think Goku would want to fight Superman. I was scrolling through, I don't know if it was Twitter or YouTube, but I saw a comment that actually struck me pretty well on the whole Goku-Superman debate. And it's like, you literally almost can't even compare the characters for a fight, because Goku, obviously, he started out as a kid. He started out as a kid who could have, I mean, you know, been crushed by a mighty Ozaru that wasn't even a high level. You know what I mean? And he grows over time. He trains. He gets stronger. He does everything he can to be the most badass guy around. Like I said, training King Kai's world, being able to achieve levels like Super Saiyan 3, Super Saiyan God, all that stuff. I mean, he's going through and he's putting in the work. Superman was kind of born with it. Superman was kind of always been this kind of God figure. And then, like the arguments brought up 100,000 times before, it depends on which Superman you're using, because sometimes Superman could be beaten by Yamcha, and then other times nothing anywhere ever could kill Superman. They just like write it in the comment. They're like, nothing anywhere ever could ever kill this Superman. No way, nuh-uh. So it's like, okay, that's a really interesting story if you have a guy who's literally invincible. Like, I don't know. That's why I guess I can see, because it was the time, like, I don't want to say around the birthing of comic book, but Superman has always just been that base, standard set foundation for superheroes. The only thing about him is that, well, he can't die no matter whatever. Except for Kryptonite, which nobody manages to use right for some reason. But anyways, how many times do you think you've watched the Dragon Ball Z series? Too many. Too many. In whole, I think I've watched GT two, three times. I think I've watched GT three whole times. I've too many to count for Dragon Ball Z. Absolutely too many to count. And then Dragon Ball, I've honestly only watched Dragon Ball twice, I think. But Dragon Ball just didn't strike me as much. No, oh my god, Thundershot, you've seen GT more than Dragon Ball. GT's really short, and I skip a lot of the shitty scenes, so I don't have to watch very long to watch all of GT, at least with the way I do it. What is your favorite DBZ theme music? That is a really good question, and I don't have an answer for you right now. That is good, though. I think it's when Goku goes Super Saiyan 1, when it's got like that piano in the background, kind of. I think that's it. I think it's either Goku Super Saiyan 1 or Gohan Super Saiyan 2, but I really like that theme. What is your favorite Dragon Ball character? If you're talking Dragon Ball, probably Roshi. Roshi was in Dragon Ball a lot more than he was in Z, and I really liked Roshi. But if you're talking about Dragon Ball Z as a whole, of course it's Super Saiyan 2 Teen Gohan. What would happen to Dragon Ball and Dragon Ball Z if Goku married Bulma instead of Chi-Chi? What would change? I think I got that question last, Ask FM. Why do you swear? Why don't you swear? I guess is my response to that. I don't know. Hold on. Okay. I guess my response to why do you swear would be, why does it matter to you that I swear? They're legitimately just words, you know what I mean? Like, you're giving them meaning if you're like, wow, that word bothers me. Like, you're the one saying that, like, because the word doesn't bother me, it's a word, you know what I mean? But if you are getting upset, that's kind of on your end, be like, you were making... That word is upsetting you because you think that, you know what I mean? Stop swearing, okay? No. Whose power increased the most between when they went to the time chamber and when they came out? I would have to say, I would really have, like, Gohan's, hands down. I don't think anybody's ever topped Gohan in how much his power changed in the time. Even Goten and Trunks, despite, like, ignore the fact that they can fuse. Just focus on how much stronger they got when they went to the time chamber. Gohan went from not being a Super Saiyan to just under the level of Super Saiyan 2. You know what I mean? Because, I mean, obviously he was just under the level of Super Saiyan 2 if he cracked into it without any training. Because after they came out of the time chamber, Gohan didn't train a day. So Gohan went from not being a Super Saiyan by a little bit, actually. I mean, if you think about it, Gohan went from not being a Super Saiyan by a little bit. When he came out, he was so far beyond a Super Saiyan, he was damn near Super Saiyan 2. So, there's that. Sorry, my chair's squeaky. Thoughts on Berserk the anime? Got that question last time. Very popular anime from the 90s. A must watch. In fact, go watch now, Damien. I'm actually watching Fairy Tail and Death Note side by side right now. So please no spoilers. I'm only like three episodes into Fairy Tail. I'm 3 episodes into Fairy Tail, 3 episodes into Death Note. I'm going to make a post on Naruto TGS, the website, about that. If I remember, a link to that, I'll be in the description down below. But, they're really good to watch side by side. I know I'm getting off subject a little bit here, but they're really, really good to watch side by side because Death Note is like this. You're in a world that, aside from Death Note and the evil spirit things that come with it, aside from Death Note being a real thing, you're pretty much in a real life world. Like, this is actually the world we live in for the most part. It's very dark themed. I mean, obviously it's got a very dark tone to it. Its name is Death Note, but it could be something that happened in the real life world, assuming somebody dropped a Death Note book into the real life world. And next to it, you have Fairy Tail, which is about magic and dragons and all that shit. And it's a very lighthearted, poppy, fun, I mean, you know, just kind of go get them anime. So I think it's a really good balance to watch them side by side. They're on complete opposite ends of the spectrum almost as far as the anime universe goes. But I'm liking them both so far. But I will have to get to Berserk when I get done with this, along with everything else people are telling me to watch. I'm just now diving into actually... hardcore anime watching, aside from all the stuff I grew up with in the 90s, so forgive me. I asked Kwame and Black and Fist this, so I want to know, if you could have any character theme from Dragon Ball, what would it be? And mine would be Perfect Cells. I don't remember the music off the top of my head right now. I would really need to think about that, but thank you, Lloyd, for the question nonetheless. Someone was telling me last time that I needed to do research and go through these questions beforehand and know my answers to all of them or know what research I need to do. But here's my thing. If I need to do research, like aside from that one was a music question. But if someone asked me a question like, oh, what would happen if Goku married Bulma, for example, I'll use that one. And someone was telling me I need to go do research on what I would actually think before I come back. I get so many questions like that in the single Ask FM video. That would be like hours of research on my end. And plus, if it's going to take me... excuse me. Sorry about that. Anyways, if it's going to take me that long to do research on a video or on the topic, I may as well just make that a video in itself one of these days. You know what I mean? Black Man's Shot. I'm assuming that's a fused Quaman name. A fused between me, Quaman, and Black and Fist thing. But anyways, I just saw the full moon. Oh no, am I turning into a grade 8? Probably not. Thunder. Who would win between Popo and Kami, Whis, Bills, and Super Saiyan 3 Goku after absorbing God powers? Teen Gohan versus Perfect Cell and Bojack. Okay, I'm just going to put that right there. Too many questions. Too many questions packed into one question. All the versus things in one time. I've got to get to a lot of questions here, you know what I mean? I only have so much time in a day. And every time I do an Ask FM, I get more questions the next day than I answered the day before. So I'm already having trouble keeping up on it. But yeah, if you're going to pack that many, and when I say too many questions in one question, that doesn't mean ask like 30 different questions as separate questions either, because I'll next those too. But just kind of, You know what I mean? Like share it around. Let everyone get a turn. You know what I mean? Ask your question. Make sure it's a good one. I mean, try to think on it. Make sure it's a good one. But if you have a couple good ones, maybe space them out. Ask like one a day or so. But if you ask a bunch of questions on my Ask FM, you were kind of cutting out other people's questions who may be slightly more courteous and only asking the minimal amount, if that makes any sense. I don't want to dawdle on that too long, but if Professor Gerald was Dr. Eggman's grandfather, wouldn't that make Maria Eggman's sister? No, actually. I think they speak of it before, but Maria was Eggman's cousin because Maria was Gerald's granddaughter on the other side of the family. But I had actually researched that before myself. But yeah, they're cousins. They're not brother and sister. But good question. I like that. I like the way you think. This question probably... By the way, that question was referring to Sonic Adventure 2 Battle and that story mode, in case anyone was super lost there. This question probably has been asked, but why isn't any human in DBZ wish to be Saiyan or as strong as Saiyan? But here's another question. Can I make you an AMV? Which subject would you like for the Sonic the Hedgehog or Dragon Ball Z? My channel is Jet2497. I'm normally not okay with people plugging their channels, but if you want to make me an AMV, man, go for it. You do DBZ or do... If you're using my gameplay, I would prefer you did Sonic Adventure 2, just because outside of fights, I only really have Battle of Z up, so... And I don't want an AMV done in Battle of Z, but... Yeah, if anyone wants to make an AMV or any kind of, like, tribute or, like, highlight video, you have 100% my permission to do that. Just link it to me when you're done is all I ask. Just let me know, hey, I made this, it's up. But if you want to make, like, a highlight video of stuff that I've done in my playthroughs, or if you want to compile some cool moments that you thought were in Dragon Ball Z fights and slap it into a video, whether you want to put music on it or whatever, I don't care. But if anyone wants to use, like, any of my content to make some kind of, like, Thundershot highlight video, or AMV like this guy wants to do or anything like that, by all means, you were 100% okay to do that. I would rather not be a part of, like, these are a highlight of a bunch of YouTubers I watch and throw it all together. Like, maybe let me know heads up before you do that. But aside from that, yeah, you were 100% okay to, like, download my videos and edit them and do whatever you want and upload them. Just as long as you tell me, like, hey, I made a highlight video for you, or hey, I made an AMV video for you. But yeah, go for it, man. But like I said, if you're using my gameplay, use Sonic Adventure 2 stuff. What would happen if Vegito became a Super Saiyan God? Would he beat Whis? I believe so. I believe if Goku and Vegeta both retain their God, like if they let Vegeta go Super Saiyan God and then they retain their God powers and they fuse via Patara earrings, I would think they would have to be, just because fusion is such a strong multiplier. Like, we had... And I've gone into detail about how strong fusion is before, but just look at Goten and Trunks, right? They weren't too stronger than the standard Super Saiyan. I don't believe they were much stronger than Goku when Goku went Super Saiyan against Frieza, right? But the fusion let them completely go by Super Saiyan 2 and straight into 3, which had only been achieved in Other World before then. So, I mean, fusion just multiplies so much. So, yeah, if Goku, who... let's run through the scalings one more time. Akira said Goku was a 7 on the scale. No, Akira said Goku was a 6 on the scale. Beerus was a 10. Whis was a 15. I think they would blow Beerus out of the water. I think they would at least give Whis a good fight if they couldn't just straight up beat him. It wouldn't surprise me if they could just straight up beat Whis if Whis is a 15 out of 10. Will there ever be another season or series of Dragon Ball? Probably not. We're probably looking at movies from here on out. Akira Toriyama has came out and said, hey... I'm too old to dive into another manga. I'm too old to do all that over again. But if... he said, hey, I'm too old to do all that over again. I'm too old to dive into a manga, but I can keep doing these movies. I can keep pumping into these movies. Because it's not nearly as big as a commitment for him to do a movie, even if it is a full-length movie, than to do an entire another series or an entire other manga. You know what I mean? But that's going to be the last question for this video. I'll be back with you guys on Thursday doing questions from the top down. Also, how I'm going to do that when I do questions from the top down is I'm going to film that video right now. So don't think you when you ask your questions today or Wednesday night or Thursday morning or whatever that they're going to make it into that video, because I'm filming this right now. I'm going to be filming Thursday's video right now on Tuesday. So it might show up next week or the week after, whenever I can get to them. But feel free to ask your questions. My Ask FM is going to be in the link down below. Also, I'm going to be live with Shadow of Mordor as soon as it comes in the package. As soon as it comes in the mail, really, really hype game. If you don't know what it is, I have a hype video I put up yesterday for it. But if you guys were ever going to make it out to one of my live streams and you haven't yet, I'll have a link video on YouTube as soon as I go live, like I said, somewhere between 3:30 and 5 Central Time. and it's going to be awesome. So make sure you guys make the stream tonight. If not, catch the videos when they go live on YouTube the next day. I want to thank all you guys for coming out. Hope you guys enjoyed. I'll see you Thursday with more questions. I'm Thundershot, and I'm out. Peace.